Mapping Food Deserts in Southern California, Part 7, Performing a Table Join. In the previous video, you learned how to refine the study area using a spatial query. In this video, you will learn how to perform a table join. In this chapter, you learned that a table join is when you establish a one-to-one relationship between two tables using a common attribute field. In the step, you will create a table join between the study area layer and the census tract CSV table for household and family income. To help you understand how this works, open the attribute table for the study area layer. The shapefile currently stores some basic information about the census tracts, including area, state codes, and county codes. However, the attribute table lacks any demographic data, such as population, income, or poverty level. If you recall from a previous step, you downloaded the information from the NHGIS about household and family income in the United States. The shapefile does not currently store this data. It is in the CSV tables you downloaded that store the household and family income data. To place that information on the map, you need to join the CSV table to the study area shapefile. The joining of the two tables requires a key. As you learned in this chapter, a key is a common field, one that exists in both tables and is used to associate them together. The NHGIS provides an attribute field that serves as a key called GIS join. In the table of contents, right-click the study area layer and select Joins and Relates, then Join. When the Join Data window appears, use the drop-down menu to choose the option Join Attributes from a Table. Next to option 1, choose the field in this layer that the join will be based on. Use the drop-down menu to select the GIS Join field. Next to option 2, choose the table to join to this layer or load the table from disk. Use the yellow file folder icon to browse to the original folder. Then, open the CSV folder and locate the CSV file for the 2016 tract that relates to the family and household income. Be sure you are in the correct folder for household and family income data and not for the total population. When you are ready, click Add. Next to option 3, choose the field in the table to base the join on. Make sure to choose the GIS join field. The ArcGIS software usually locates the attribute field that serves as a key automatically. Leave all of the other default settings. When you are ready, click OK. The contents of the two tables are now merged. To view this, open the attribute table for the study area layer. Sometimes the column widths are set too wide after a table join. You can fix this issue by clicking the Table Options button and selecting Restore Default Column Widths. You may need to scroll to the right to see the contents of the CSV table joined to the layer. As you can see, the records from each table are matched using the GIS join field. A table join is a temporary condition. To make the join permanent, export the layer. Make sure there are no features selected. If necessary, use the Clear Selected Features button. In the table of contents, right-click on the study area layer and select Data, then Export Data. Click the yellow file folder icon and navigate to your working folder. Call the file Poverty Status and save it as a shapefile. After saving the new shapefile, add the layer to the map. You no longer need the study area layer, so remove it from the table of contents. Right-click on the study areas layer and select Remove. Now only the Poverty Status layer remains in the table of contents. Using what you learned in the previous step, perform a table join between the poverty status layer and the CSV table for the total population. Try not to confuse the file with the household and family income data. After performing a table join, export the data. Save the new file to your working folder. Call the file Population and Poverty. Add the new layer to the map and remove the poverty status layer. In the next video, you will learn how to add a new field to the attribute table.